welcome to Ion Entertainment. I'm Dawna Lee Heising, and today our guests are Melinda Bennett and Taylor Graham, and they're the stars of the award-winning film Kill Devil Hill. So welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, now let's start with your backgrounds. Melinda, where did you grow up?
I was actually born in Virginia, and I lived there for 12 years, and then moved to North Carolina, went to school, college at East Carolina University. Mm-hmm. Have a degree in dance and theater, and then moved to LA 10 years ago.
Well, tell us what kind of dance.
I'm trained in jazz, tap, ballet. I used to teach ballroom dancing for quite a while, so a little bit of everything.
Oh my gosh, okay. Now tell us where you grew up.
I actually grew up in North Carolina. Mm-hmm. So I grew up in North Carolina, a small town called Enfield, North Carolina. Mm-hmm. And went to East Carolina University.
Why does that sound familiar?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Right. We actually both went to the same college.
So did
you
know each other?
We didn't meet until we got to LA. We met at an acting class in LA.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, okay.
Kind of a coincidence.
Yeah.
When did you come to LA?
I've been in LA for about 8 years now.
Okay. Now, did you always want to be in showbiz? I mean, I know you started out in dance really young.
Yeah. But. I started dancing when I was 8 years old and doing plays in middle school and high school and just fell in love with dancing and then shortly after acting and quite honestly knew from a very young age that this is what I was supposed to be doing and knew that I would be in California at some point. So, yeah.
Okay, and what about you?
I actually got a business degree. I got a degree in marketing. But,
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, but I always took theater classes, and once I got my degree, I went out to Los Angeles and pursued acting.
Okay, so you knew that you were going to do that.
Oh, yeah.
Did you want the business degree as a backup then, or was it helping with your acting?
No, I actually just got it just to prepare myself for the business part of acting.
Okay.
Just to, you know.
I mean, you have such a perfect face. I'm looking at you.
Oh, come on.
Both of you are beautiful people. I can see why the film is award-winning. And I know that you're really talented, too. So tell us about the acting class that you met in.
It was one of the, quite honestly, many classes I've taken when I first started taking classes out here and somewhere in Hollywood. And I actually heard him talking, and I knew he was from North Carolina with the accent. And we just started talking and figured out we both went to the same school and we actually know some of the same people. It's just ironic we met out here.
So,
yeah. So where do you both live? Are you both live in L.A.?
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. And tell me about your career. How did it start? What was your big break?
My first speaking part was on a TV show called Lucky with John Corbett. Mm-hmm. I was on FX. It lasted 2 seasons. I played a poker player with him. That was my first thing, and then from there, have been doing different guest spots on TV and had a small part.
You've got a great resume.
Thanks. Did a small part in the movie Knocked Up, which is probably one of the bigger things I've done.
Uh-huh.
And
what did you do in that?
I played a nurse, one of the nurses that she goes to many doctors to figure out who she wants to be.
Yeah, that was a great movie.
Yeah, so I played one of the many nurses in the movie, so. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you get an agent as soon as you came out to Hollywood?
No, I actually did some theater when I first moved out here, and I did some sketch comedy and improv shows for the first year that I was here just to get involved, and then I started taking a few classes, and it was my second year here when I finally got an agent.
Oh, okay.
And now I'm on my fifth agent.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, what's your favorite? You're a dancer, and you've done comedy, and you've done theater. So what is it that you like the best, or do you like everything?
I just like the creative process. I like, you know, with acting, I love the part of creating a character and finding the truth within the character and something relatable. I love comedy, you know, I love to laugh and hopefully make other people laugh. The dramatic side is always fun too because I feel like you can really go really deep and, you know, find parts of yourself in doing that. I honestly love it all. I love the whole process of it.
And you still dance?
I do. I danced more when I was a little bit younger, but I have a dance agent. And I still dance out here sometimes. But my main focus now really is on the acting. So, but I do it for fun.
Well, then you could do like a, you could be on So You Think You Can Dance. Is that the name of the show?
One of the many.
Yeah.
Okay, now tell us about your career. What was your big break?
I did a little bit on Days of Our Lives, just a very little short thing. From there, I actually co-wrote and starred in a film called Muse. It's a feature film that should be out next year, actually. We'll see what happens with it.
Well, congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
So you co-wrote it? Who did you write it with?
With a director by the name of Eric Badros. And my co-star was a very talented woman by the name of Heather Weeks. We got together and started writing. We wrote two scripts, and we decided to pick one. And we actually picked the one that we thought was going to bring more colors out and whatnot. It was actually a very challenging role, but it definitely paid off, so we'll see what happens with it.
Have you written before? Did you study it in school?
No, I didn't. You know, I've always had a passion for it. When I was younger, I kind of would do it as a hobby, but I kind of, you know, acting was always my thing, but I just decided to kind of, you know, give it a shot and see where it goes.
Who came up with the idea?
Well, initially I was supposed to do a feature film. I believe New Line was behind it, and something happened with that project. So we just kind of decided to create, you know.
Well, can you tell us a little bit about the plot of your film?
Sure. I play the role of a agoraphobic alcoholic.
He wrote that.
So it's a comedy. Speaking of which, I started off doing improv comedy as well. That was kind of, I didn't know that about her. But so this gentleman, he a very talented painter, and he kind of has he loses a loved one and kind of falls into despair. So
okay.
It's kind of his journey to. Number one, it's a sci-fi psychological thriller, so it's kind of it takes place in the future and whatnot, so it's has a lot of dimensions to it.
Oh, that sounds really interesting. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know that you're not an alcoholic and you're not agoraphobic, right?
No.
So that, I mean, how could you bring colors to the part then?
I actually tailored the character towards Jackson Pollock and a bull. So I kind of just took those two, you know, an animal type character to a famous painter who kind of had the same type of inner turmoil, you know, to seek perfection, I guess. It should be interesting.
Oh, well, that's great. Okay, so that film's coming out next year.
Mm-hmm.
And is there a website?
No, not right now. I believe they're in post-production right now. There's a few other things we need to take care of, but yeah.
Okay, and do either of you have a website?
Right now I just have my IMDb page that
okay.
I use. Okay,
well, I know, but it's a great page.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
What about you?
I do.
What is it?
Taylorgram.net.
Okay, so we'll check it out then. Okay, now let's get to the film that you've won awards in, Kill Devil Hill. Now, how did you get the role there?
I submitted myself on a casting that Bobby had posted on one of the many actors' websites, and read the breakdown and thought, wow, it's kind of me, you know, a little bit. And I like the fact that it was based on a town in North Carolina, and I know Kill Devil Hill. I know where that is.
Oh, okay.
And, I just answered the ad or the casting, basically, and he called me in for an audition, so...
Yeah, he said that you look just like the character, though. And he knew exactly when you walked in that you were the part.
Yay.
So where is Kill Devil Hill? Is it close to where you were born?
No, it's more on the coast of North Carolina.
Is it famous? Mm-hmm.
I think it's just famous because of the name, honestly, you know, because it has such a distinct name. And I've only been there once, so I don't really know too much about it. I just know that it exists. Mm-hmm. There is a town called Kill Devil Hill.
Yeah. Okay, so who got cast first?
I think I did.
Yeah, Melinda did.
Okay.
And then I actually suggested Taylor for the role of Jesse because I had worked with him several times, and he fit the profile pretty well. And, you know, I knew that Bobby was having, you know, a time trying to find the lead guy, so I suggested Taylor, and he came in and, you know, read and
audition,
stuff.
Audition, yeah, for Bobby. Yeah.
So what have you worked on together before?
A couple of short films and...
You met in acting class, though, right?
We met in acting class, various scene work. We auditioned for the Actors Studio together
a while ago. We did,
Oh, you did?
Yeah. So, yeah,
What did we do, Solana?
Yeah, we did a short film about 4 years ago now.
Yeah.
Now, I think that was the first thing we worked on together.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I've known Taylor for about, I don't know, 5 or 6 years now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like brother and sister in real life.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just funny to play husband and wife.
Yes, that's normally what we get.
That's normally what we get cast, and
I know the
brother sister
couple.
Right. Oh, my little sweet pea.
Oh, stop. We're, it's like my
Yeah, exactly right.
Okay. Okay. So, tell us about Kill Devil Hill. What was it like? How is it? I know your character is interesting. So what can you tell us about your character?
Yeah, well, Jesse, Jesse Reed, he, a family man, just a very down-to-earth kind of guy. He loves his two sons and his wife, very loyal to his family, and the family kind of goes on a little trip, and the youngest boy, Joey, actually stumbles across a... like a little ritual.
Yeah, I saw the trailer. That's
oh, you did. Okay. So you saw the whole pentagram and all that. Yeah. So the little boy stumbles upon that, and I kind of am trying to, you know, I find him, I discover him in the woods, and end up taking him back home. And yeah, so you know, I take him back home, and my beautiful wife here ends up tucking him in bed, and when the night falls and the moon comes out, some weird stuff kind of goes down.
Okay, and did it have to do with the little boy seeing the, you know, the witchcraft
stuff? Absolutely.
Yeah, it's all related.
Okay, but it doesn't affect the boy, it affects someone else, right? I don't know how much we can talk about it.
Yeah, I know,
really
I know.
It's an interesting film.
Well, I mean, yeah, it does.
We don't want to give it all away.
Yeah,
But actually, we're going to attach the film to the end of this for the people who want to see the show. So.
Okay, so let's spoil it for the people.
Well, I don't know what, what did they say we could talk about.
So the ending is this. No.
Yeah, let's talk about the ending.
Yeah. I don't even know the ending. I'm just asking
you. Well, we don't want to ruin it for you.
Yeah, just some things happen in the middle of the night that, you know,
that are scary.
Okay. Yeah.
They're really scary.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, you know, the film, it's a short film,
mm-hmm.
and it's won awards, and it's been selected as one of the top 10 films in one of the horror sites, and it's the only short film, so it must be spectacular. Did you guys know that you were working on something special?
I knew the script was very unique when I read it, and it was... a lot of, to me, unexpected things happen for this, what seems like just a really normal, nice, loving family.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, short film, you only have a little bit of time to tell a really good story.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So I thought Bobby did a great job with the writing and telling the story in that amount of time. So it was exciting to work on it.
Did he work with you on your characters, or did you develop the backgrounds yourself?
Some of both.
And since you guys know each other,
It was
Taylor and I definitely talked about it after we got cast a little bit, and then from the time that we got cast on it to the time that we shot, it wasn't too terribly long in between.
No,
so you know, we talked about it when we were on set a little bit, and
but I mean the crew was amazing.
Yeah,
I mean they just so professional and so I mean, they had everything down to a science.
Yeah.
So it was that helped, you know, dramatically.
And I bet the chemistry between you two is fantastic in the film because I can see it right now. So.
Yeah.
We have fun working together.
Yeah, we do.
It's good.
It's fun.
Yeah.
Okay, so any plans to work together again?
Well, funny, we were just talking about it on the way in. I was like, I wonder what we're gonna
what
our next
do next?
Thing is gonna do.
Yeah.
Well, It's going to be the full-length version of the film, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hope so.
Yeah. We'll see.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's bring Ace into the show.
Okay.
Okay.